I want to talk today to the person who is saying, I am serious about closing the wage gap for Black women. Because as we're sitting here today, she is earning 61 cents to the dollar of a white heterosexual male. So what can we do to change that? What can we do to really see a difference? Because right now, a Black woman has to work until 2100, whatever you want to call that year, 2100, before she's going to earn the same salary as a Black male. Are you serious? Look at that. Are you still going to be working? I know I'm not going to be working at 2100. So what can we do today so we can begin to hit that gap? One thing is we can take negotiations off the table, because negotiations do not help women, and they definitely do not help Black women. When women start to negotiate, those plans, those strategies, all the tactics that she had laid out, all of a sudden begin to start working against her and not for her, and especially Black women. She begins to be labeled as aggressive. And basically what's happening to that person who's sitting on the other side of the table, they're saying to themselves, she doesn't even know her place. And so that is not something that is helpful, because that unconscious bias that they have is hurting her. So why not just put the money out on the table? You know exactly what you wanted to pay her. Give it to her without her asking, without having that conversation of going back and forth. The second thing is, why not do an internal look? Look in your company right now, in your organization, and start looking at the education, the experience of people all holding the same job titles, and look at their salary. Do you see that there's some inequities? And if there are, what are you going to do about adjusting them? And when you see those inequities, dig a little deeper and ask yourself, where are those inequities lying with? With who? What kind of women? And I'm talking about race. And I'm also talking about when you're talking about gender as well. Because what we've known is that even for transgender women, they're also seeing that they're being punished and when it comes to salary. Also, when we see where we're talking about women who are in their sexual orientation, lesbian women are being punished. So if you have a Black lesbian woman or a Black transgender woman, their salary has definitely been punished even more than a Black heterosexual woman. And of course, more than a white heterosexual woman as well. So what can we do about it? Start looking inside and seeing where you can make adjustments. Another inside look would be in your salary promotions and how you give promotions out. So when you're giving salary raises, or when you're having annual performance appraisals and salary is attached to it, when you're talking about meritocracy, how is that working for the Black woman in your workplace? And what I want us to look at is, where has she not won because her salary raise was less? If we all look at the Lilly Ledbetter case, we know she started out just like her other colleagues. It was over time, over many years, that her salary, the gap became wider and wider and wider. And how can you change that? By simply paying attention to it and having objectives and having very clear guidelines in place to begin to close that gap. Look, this is affecting her retirement, her pension, and she doesn't get this right while she's still in the workplace. I know you're serious about changing and closing that wage gap, and that's why I implore you to do something today. Look at the negotiations, look at internally, look at pay raises, and also look to see across, do an audit on your salaries. Have a great day, and can't wait for us to talk again about how we can make the workplace better for women.